Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you just how quick and easy it is to set up LiveScrypt, Epiphan's real-time live transcription device. Ideal for your events or your live streams if you want to make them more accessible and of course more engaging. So this is the device itself, and of course in the box you'll get one of these and you'll get a power cable. So let's go ahead and get this plugged in. LiveScrypt is built on the same platform as Epiphan's all-in-one production unit, the Pearl Mini, so looks and dimensions-wise, they are pretty much the same. LiveScrypt needs to be connected to the internet because it uses a cloud-based AI to do that transcribing. So we need to connect an Ethernet cable with internet connectivity to the back of the device. It uses Google's deep learning network to provide transcription with around 92% accuracy. It can understand multiple languages, accents such as my thick northern accent, slang, and even has a profanity filter. Now of course Google are always improving their AI transcription, and when those improvements happen, because this is cloud-based, those improvements will be available immediately on the LiveScrypt. When we turn it on, we're prompted to pair the LiveScrypt with an AV Studio account. AV Studio is essentially Epiphan's cloud-based management system. So we just head over to avstudio.com and create an account. In my case, I already have one, so I'll just log in. And then we can head over to the LiveScrypt tab and pair our unit just by copying in the code that it displays on its screen. Once done, we'll see the screen update and we're ready to go. Well, almost. Firstly, you do need to set up your billing information on AV Studio, because to use LiveScrypt, there is an operational cost, and that cost is $9.95 per hour of transcription. Once you've got those billing details in, we are then ready to go. So now we need to set up our audio input. And we do have plenty of options on the rear to do this. It does also support embedded HDMI and SDI audio, which is going to be ideal if you're taking an output from a production unit such as the Pearl Mini, or even directly from a camera feed. Once we're all set, we can hit start on the top corner of the screen and our transcription will automatically begin. And we'll get confirmation of this because we'll see the live transcription on the screen. We can output the live transcription through the HDMI output, and by default this will just mirror what we see on the built-in screen. But if we jump into the settings, we can tweak the general look and font size. So for events, we could run this HDMI output to the screens around the event space for your audience to see. But we can also display a QR code on that HDMI output, which when scanned by a mobile device opens up the web browser and displays the transcription live in real time. You can actually share this QR code and URL with your audience before your event goes live, because it is visible within your AV Studio account. For live streaming applications, you could encode the LiveScrypt's output as a dedicated live stream. This would work well if using a platform that will allow for two live streams to be displayed on screen at the same time, your main program, so your video mix, and of course then your transcribed live stream. Now, if you're using a platform that will only allow you to use one live stream at a time, then you can always route the output of the LiveScrypt into your main video switcher or production software. You can then just overlay the transcription on top of your program feed. You also have the option of outputting the transcription on a green background, so in your production switcher, you could use a chroma key to get that transparency. When the event is finished, we simply hit the stop button, and straight away, if I jump onto my AV Studio account, I can see that I can now download a text or SRT file of that session. So I hope you found this intro to LiveScrypt useful. If you've got any questions, do just put them in the comments and I will get back to you. And if you want to find out some more information, just head over to the Holden website. Thanks for watching.